How many of you think mental health of students is a big problem in your schools? Every single one of you.
This group, four teachers, a behavioral specialist, and a social worker from across the metro, are on the front lines of a mental health crisis in our schools.
How many of you have ever had a situation or a student where you feared there could be violence in your school? Almost all of you.
Sharing stories of kids in pain, even of hearing threats.
I hear, I'm gonna shoot up to school.
Like one of my kids who would come in every day, put his head down, put his hood over his head, and just immediately withdraw before anything would even happen.
I can't even just think of one. I have hundreds of faces coming across.
And yet nationwide, schools are short on counselors, and the ones they have are often overwhelmed, according to federal data we reviewed. The American School Counselor Association recommends no more than 250 students to one counselor. But nearly 85% of schools miss that mark across the country.
And here in Minnesota, our investigation found that even when you add in specialized school psychologists and social workers, many districts still fall short.
Do you have enough school counselors, social workers, psychologists to help all the kids who need it?
No.
No.
Not even close.
Not even remotely close.
No. We have one guidance counselor for our whole school. We don't have a social worker anymore because our district was having some funding issues.
Why does it matter? Ask Aaron Starr.
Every day that we don't offer these kids someone to talk to is another day that they're wallowing in their own pain and possibly reaching that edge of violence.
He almost reached that edge 25 years ago as a bullied teen in Colorado.
I had a plan to get a gun and I wanted to go into the big glass doors in the side of the school, into the food court area, and shoot as many people as I could right away.
Telling his story now because he believes a school counselor could have helped but wasn't there. Fortunately, a friend was, and Stark didn't follow through.
They really need to get to know you and feel
Kathy Dades, the school social worker in our group, says with so many students, it's impossible to treat everyone in need.
So much of my time or our staff time is spent in more of those acute things that come up daily. The kid who had a neighborhood shooting, or the kid who was put in foster care last night.
So you're putting out fires.
We're putting out fires.
Remember, the national recommendation is no more than 250 students for every counselor. But when KARE 11 surveyed large metro area schools, adding up all the counselors, psychologists, and social workers, we found districts far from meeting that goal. Moundsview, 520 to 1. Lakeville, 455 to 1. These other districts miss too, although not as badly. Minnetonka, Wayzata, Eden Prairie, Shakopee, Anoka-Hennepin, White Bear Lake, North St. Paul Maplewood, Stillwater, and Edina.
Is that an acceptable or safe level?
I think that's a challenging level.
Gary Amoroso leads the Minnesota Association of School Administrators.
I think the whole concept of safety of our students is a number one priority, and the mental health piece now is a very prominent part of that conversation.
So why are so many Minnesota schools failing to meet the national recommendation? Amoroso says it's a matter of money and a culture that prioritizes test scores.
When the focus is on reading, writing, and arithmetic, that is where the resources go most of the time. And the support services don't get the resources they probably need.
Services that are often scarce in their communities.
Because you might be the only help they're getting.
Right.
Leaving teachers to cope with kids' trauma, their anxiety, their depression, hoping their efforts are enough to keep their classrooms healthy and safe.
Because right now we're very much reactionary. And what's happening, again, it's putting out those fires, and that's not a really healthy state of being for the children or for educators, for that matter.
We need to act. We can't wait 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 months.
Minnesota does have a program that puts private mental health professionals in schools. Education advocates would like to see it expanded. So if you are concerned about this issue in your child's school, what can you do? Talk to your local school board and your lawmakers. For KARE 11 Investigates, I'm Lauren Lemanchek.